Welcome back to Holo Holo. I'm Kat Iniba with the show that aims to spotlight our very own talent, especially those making us proud in the entertainment industry. And joining us today back in the studio is Giovanni Ortega and his leading actress in his upcoming project, Mary Kamitaki. Welcome. Thank you guys for being here today.
Thanks for having us.
Now, Gio, I mentioned your latest project, you're directing a Tony Award-winning musical, right? Spring Awakening?
Yeah, we're directing Spring Awakening, the musical, which won and garnered some Tonys in 2007? For 2007. Yeah, music by Duncan Sheik and lyrics by Steven Sader. It's a really great adaptation of the play version.
Right. Any pressure because it's won all these awards? You're like, oh,
a lot.
But it is going to play at the Pomona Theater, right?
Yeah, Pomona
College Theater and Dance.
Yes.
November 20th. Now, Mary, how did you become a part of the project?
Well, in high school, I was always very into musical theater, and I listened to Spring Awakening, and I knew all the songs, and I was a huge fan. And then when I heard that we were doing it at Pomona, I auditioned. I, you know, prepared for weeks, and was super excited and nervous, and was lucky enough to be cast.
Yes. So. And you play the main actress?
I play Wendla.
Yes. Tell me a little bit more about Wendla.
Well, so Spring Awakening is sort of the story of this group of teenagers coming of age and discovering their sexuality and just dealing with a lot of the pressures they face as they're becoming adults. And they come, because they come from this very repressed community and society, it's not the lightest of subject matter, but it is, the music keeps it really fun and energetic. So I play a character who goes through sort of a huge transition and sort of loses her innocence and really just comes of age in this difficult world, so.
And Gio, were you familiar with the piece?
I was. I actually saw the play version when I was in college.
Right.
That's a while back.
We're not gonna talk about it.
But, and when the opportunity came, I was like, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, how did the opportunity come?
I was asked, you know, I'm teaching there right now, and they approached me, asked if I was interested in doing the musical. Like Mary said, I knew the music, and I've known the play for over a decade. And I think it's so amazing because, like, as second generation immigrants, you know, we always have to deal with like first generation families who are not repressed necessarily, but very conservative. So that's like how I connected to the play of like these high school students who are just filled with angst of not being able to voice their opinion.
Express themselves.
Exactly, exactly. So that's how I connected with it.
And then you were also telling me that it's a multi-ethnic cast.
Oh, definitely.
Right? Was that like something that you consciously did, or was it kind of subconscious?
I was consciously aware of having a cast that is credible and talented, regardless of the color of their skin and their sexual orientation, religion, or gender. I think that's just like my thing as an artist. It's like at this day and age, I don't think it matters what you are,
matter,
who
right?
you are, but if you're talented, definitely go for it. But I know that there's a very keen awareness of making sure that the cast is a blend of different different backgrounds.
Yeah. Tell me what the rehearsals have been like, Mary.
Well, the rehearsals have actually been...
Yeah, your director is right here. But you can't cut her out anymore. It's too late.
Actually, the rehearsals have been wonderful. I mean, it takes up, you know, all of my free time, but that's, you know, that's something that I wanted, and this is like what I enjoy doing more than anything else, and the cast is fantastic. Everybody is, you know, just really welcoming and friendly, and it's a lot of like intense, really heavy subject matter, and it's like probably the most difficult role I've ever even attempted, so this is, you know, it's really great to work with all these people who are so supportive and just inclusive and wonderful.
Very challenging for you, right?
Yes.
Now, a little background on you. I hear that you're from Hawaii.
I am.
And the show actually airs in Hawaii. Do you have a message to all of our viewers there?
Come see the show.
Come fly and see the show. Right. You started acting when you're, what, just 8 years old?
Well, yeah. When I was 8, I just started like a sort of a drama club in my backyard with my friends, and we
Wait, where in Hawaii?
This is okay. Well, so I'm from Kau, which is sort of the southern point of the Big Island, and so this was around volcano area. So if anyone knows volcano, that's sort of where I started, and I got really into theater in high school and pretty much devoted all my time to it. So I've been, you know, acting in like a sort of just casual way since I could.
Yeah. And now you're here in Pomona, the same college that your parents met at, you say?
Yes, actually.
How weird, how ironic, right?
Wow,
now, for more information on Spring Awakening, where can we go?
You could go to Pomona. .edu,
okay.
And that'll lead you to all the links where you could buy tickets.
Right.
And it's really not that far from LA. It's like 35 minutes away.
I grew up in West Covina. It's like right down the corner.
West Covina. I passed by there every day.
Right. Yes. And it does start November 20th.
November 20th.
Thank you. Guys.
21st, 22nd, 23rd.
Thank you guys so much for being here today.
Thanks for having us again.
Again, to catch Spring Awakening, the rock musical, you can head to the website that you see on the screen. It is playing from November 20th through the 23rd in Pomona. We'll be back.